Here.
Kim Jin-cho, here. Yu Jae-hyun, here. Shin Hae-sung,
here.
Yang Dae-young,
here.
Yang Chang-woo,
here.
Won Jae-young,
here.
Lee Jin-woo,
here.
Choi Jin-hwa, Bang Seung-min,
here.
Hwang Seong-min,
here.
Jung Min-sun,
here.
Hwang Seong-min,
here.
Min Ji-hong,
here.
You think
push
up? Okay.
Sure.
All right, guys.
He, she using Korean.
I know. Okay. Let's get it together. Let's start. We're going to do our warm-up. I suggest when you do your warm-up today that you really put some effort into it because we're going to have a speaking day today. And we're going to have a little bit of a speaking game. And the winner of that game is going to win some good valuable prizes for the
class.
Wow. I suggest that when we do our warm-up, you turn your lights on. Alright? And do your best. Think of this like a speaking test, like I always say, just think of it like a speaking test and complete sentences, all that stuff. Okay?
Yeah.
So we'll do this for 5 minutes. Question is, who is the most influential person in your life and why? So just your partner, two. Please answer using your best English. Yeah. Not just English, your best English, okay?
Yeah.
All right. 5 minutes, go ahead and talk with your partner about this. Go ahead and start.
5 minutes?
Have you thought about this before?
No.
Okay. Does anybody want to volunteer? Just do a couple, hear from a couple people before we start.
Why already?
let's have Tom.
Oh.
Tell us about the most influential person in your life. Why?
My influential person is my science teacher in my middle school, academic school student. Because at that time, I didn't study well, and I always played with my friends. But she always teach me
enthusiastically.
Yes.
Try it. Enthusiastically.
Enthusiastically.
Okay, good.
When I have a middle school test,
yeah,
she asked me to go her home with me. Mm-hmm. And she called me until 3 a.m. Even though she is only academic school teacher. She called my mother when I went to kiss you with my friend. She was, so at that time, I changed my mind and I studied very hard.
Alright, great time. Let's do one more person. Is there any volunteer? If not, then we'll have Tom choose wherever he wants to hear. Tom, you choose. Choose well. Somebody who might be interesting to listen to. Who do you think it would be?
Rio.
Alright, Rio. Rio. Simple, really simple, clear English. Try to do the best. Who's the most influential person in your life?
My most influential person is not just one. Not only my father and but also my whole family.
Okay.
But the meaning of my family is include cousin or aunt or uncle. Yeah.
Thank you.
Because we usually meet together or we often meet together because my father's family are living nearby Gangnam, so we usually meet together, and our cousin is almost the same age, similar age, so we are usually meet together, and we think of same mind and think of.
How are they influential? How do they change?
When we meet together, then if I have a problem or something, some worry things, mm-hmm, then I can talk about them, mm-hmm, and they are advice to me or help me or give me some information because they are almost same age but they are more older than me.
Yeah.
So it is very impressive to me.
Alright, so they're similar age but a little older.
Yeah, a little older.
So they give you advice.
Yeah.
Okay, great. Fine, that's the warm up. That's enough of that. Just keep that up here. Now, today we're not going to be using the speaking book, but we will use it next time. Alright, so make sure you bring it next time. Today is going to be more of a I guess it's not a game, mm-hmm. but it's a little bit more of an activity where you guys are going to be active. Okay. So for our speaking, last time when I talked about speaking, and when I talked about maybe if you're doing your speaking test, what do I always say is the most important thing to remember when you're giving an answer or when you're talking? Let's get some ideas up here. Let's review what we talked about last time. So you're doing your speaking. How do you do it well? What makes good speech? Okay, what?
Clear pronunciation.
Okay, so clear pronunciation. Yeah, of course. So now we work on pronunciation a lot. So when you're talking every day, like these warm-ups and stuff like that, that's when you really have to focus. Good pronunciation, if you don't focus, is never going to improve, right? It's just going to stay the same. So it takes concentration. Good. Good pronunciation. What else?
Intonation.
Intonation goes in there. Good. Having some sort of variation in your voice. Framing important points. Real. This is an important point. Kind of frame that, right?
Intonation.
Good. What else?
Improve.
Okay, let's just say simple and concise. That's a big one. What does concise mean?
Simple.
Okay, not exactly. What is concise?
Simple, but very intelligible words and simple.
Good. Very. The words that you use are the right words, and they, but they're not overly complicated. The opposite would be what? The opposite of concise is
wording.
Yeah, it's kind of wordy. Wordy is someone who kind of says a lot of words, but they're not as, each word is not as meaningful. We know that. So we don't like wordy, do we? Right? We don't want wordy. We want concise. What else?
Detailed description.
Detail, that's a good one. So offering details. And what about those details? We want them to be, we don't want them to be, the opposite, it would be just too general, kind of meaningless words. Like, oh, I like it. Oh, it's good. When you say, oh, I like it or it's good, it doesn't really have much meaning. We want you to explain why is it good, why is it meaningful. You know, give us information. I don't want to pull that information out for me. I want you to just offer that information. So these are all good things for speaking. Anything else? What?
Use complete sentences.
Complete sentences, yeah. Maybe not so important for every day, but for a speaking test or something formal, if you're in a formal situation, you definitely want to use complete sentences. What else?
Good grammar.
Yeah, well, definitely grammar.
Good.
And when you're using good grammar, it's the same as good clear pronunciation. It takes a little bit of focus. That's why I always ask you guys, have your lights on, you know, be here, otherwise the improvement's not going to happen. So we have to focus. There's a bit of concentration when you're speaking, right? Especially in a new language, it takes a little extra concentration to push out those things. Anything else?
Creative.
Oh, that's good. I like that. Having some sort of, maybe some new information, present some new creative information. This one is quite difficult to do at times, I'm sure. Maybe you can't always do that, but yeah, if you can do that. And maybe what that means is taking other information. Maybe you saw something in the news. You know, maybe you bring that into the conversation. Or, you know, you remember something somebody said and just kind of bringing something, connecting points in a conversation. Oh, that's a very good point, Jeremy. You know, I just read something about that the other day in the news when they said this, connecting points. All right. Excellent, guys. Wow. Awesome. Amazing. You want another one?
gauge your listener's reaction.
Oh, good.
Yeah.
Gauging the listener's reaction. So, yeah, because they seem like they're drifting away, like they're losing it. You know, does it seem like you're boring them? Does it seem, you know, what does it seem like the listener's reaction is? That's excellent, Sharon. It's on fire today.
Love it.
All right, fine. Good review. So let me now explain to you about the activity we're going to do. But before I tell you the activity, let me tell you about the prizes. One person is going to win these prizes, and I hope to get you excited about them. I want you motivated to win. So there's three things. The winner is going to win three things.
Wow.
One is I always put you in your seats, right? For 1 week, you can choose to sit anywhere you want.
Oh.
Anywhere. Oh, I wanted to sit there. I wanted to sit next to Jeremy, or whatever. So that's one. That's not it, though. We got more.
What do you got to do?
The second thing is, you know, we do pronunciation homework quite often. The next pronunciation homework, you don't have to do it. You have a free pass. Just throw that out. And no problem. Take a little stress off you guys. So that's another thing. And it's not done. There's one more thing. Our next presentation is our final presentation. It's very important. And we're going to be doing a best presentation in this class so we can all watch. The final thing is you can decide when you'll do it. You can go first, second, third, fourth, last, anywhere you want. You can decide any position that you want to be in. So you get those three things. Three big prizes that would maybe, you know, be so. I hope that you guys turn your lights on. I hope that you're here, and I hope you do your best. Because I'm not joking when I say any one of you could win it. There's nobody in here I'm like, well, they're not going to win it. I think that anyone could possibly win this. So what we're going to do then is each one of you are going to write one simple question that similar to what we used up here.
Yeah.
And then after you write one simple question, that should only take a minute or two. I'm going to come around and just look at it and say, okay, good. I'm just going to check that it's okay. You're going to use that question, and you're going to form the two circles. You're going to have an inside circle of people and the outside circle. And you're going to imagine that you're at our speaking test, the final NCUK speaking test. And each person will have a partner facing them, outside circle, inside circle. And you're going to simply ask your question to them. And then you'll hear seven different people's answer because they're going to rotate around.
Yeah.
And what you're going to do is you're going to vote, you're going to think in your mind about this stuff. And thinking about this, you're going to choose who you think did the best and did that the best. Now, it's not the person who talks the most, it's not, you know, it's the person that is the most concise, they give details, they're easy to understand, and they answer the question. So let me write that, just so you're clear, good job with this. I'm going to make this a little bit more simple so you guys know what you're looking for. You guys are looking for concise, detailed, and clarity. Now, clarity means pronunciation, grammar, all of that stuff, but it's easy to understand. I understand them easily. So these are the three things you're looking for. After you listen to all of the people, the seven people, I have a voting app up front. The voting app has a ballot with all of your names, and each person will come up here, and they're going to vote for one person that you think is the best. Okay? After the voting is done, this program will show who the top three people are. The top three people will then come to the front, and they're going to have one final competition among those three people. And I'm going to be the judge. how well you do it. And I'm going to use this as my criteria. And I'm going to be the final judge. And out of those three, I'm going to choose one person. And then they get all of those prizes. They walk away with all the glory. Brian, you could win. Fleur, you could win. Julia, you could win. You guys have a really good chance. All of you guys have a really good chance. So, right now what we're going to do is we're going to start with you writing a very simple question, but something maybe you would like to hear the answer to. Maybe you are curious about that. So, write a simple question. Once you're finished, raise your hand. I'm going to come over and say yes or no. It's okay or no. So let's just take a minute or two. Just one simple question. Any question, but think about something you really like, something you'd really like to hear the answer to. I got it. Somewhat interesting to be nice. Don't use a yes-no question.
Of course,
because they don't. There's nothing, nowhere to go. Do you like spaghetti?
Yes.
There's nowhere to talk.
A good example might be the one on the board.
After you finish writing a question, just raise your hand real quick.
And they'll have
Don't answer. After that, the inside circle, after that, will rotate this way. Okay?
Yeah.
Understand?
Yeah.
Okay, so just everybody stand up.
Crazy.
Okay, stand up. Outside? Rio.
Come right here.
Outside. Who's outside?
B.
Okay. Jeremy here.
Outside?
Yeah. Here?
Outside?
Inside or?
Outside. Yes, you guys. Yeah.
Stand here inside? You're outside?
Outside? Hey, back up to the one.
I don't want to say this,
but I
thought. Does everybody have a partner?
Hey.
Rio, who is your partner?
Come on, back.
Rio, who is your partner?
Here.
Okay.
Great. Great. Great.
Hey, you.
Now, if you can, just try to spread out a little bit. Spread out a little bit.
Come on.
Come on,
spread out. Spread out.
Come on, spread out.
Come on.
Spread out that with Julian, a little bit more and a little bit. Tom. Okay. Does everybody understand what we're going to do?
Okay. Yeah.
Does everybody understand what you're listening for?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Concise details and clarity.
Yeah.
You have 1 minute and 30, and then the next person goes. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Good luck.
And
I'm
Remember, you're imagining that this is a speaking exam, so please try to relax, try to make good sentences, don't be wild. Okay. Do your best. Okay, go ahead.
Yeah.
listen up a sec. We're halfway through now. You're halfway finished. So remember to keep focused. We have the other half to go. But remember, if we're going to improve, you need to concentrate and focus on what you're saying. So we're almost finished. Good luck.
I'm not going to be able to do that.
Nichols. Good. Think about these things up here. All right? Okay, go for it.
Hello.
Thank you.
For you, individually, what do you think you can improve on?
Just a couple ideas. Everybody was perfect?
No.
Vocabulary? Okay, so using more more robust vocabulary? A bigger, more depth to your vocabulary?
Yeah.
Okay. So think about that stuff. How could you do that? How would you be able to... You know, we're having a little vocabulary list that I asked you to do, so really think about that for you. What about somebody else?
Trying to use details.
Try to give what?
Details.
Yeah, giving details, offering details. That's going to be nice for your tests, but, you know, when you're just talking with people in general, they want to have you have something to say. So, again, giving details, being descriptive, telling stories, giving examples. Are all good ways of doing that. Alright, fine. What we're going to do now is we're going to vote. Each person is going to vote for one person, not yourself, Stanley. And when you vote, I want you to consider not if they're your friend, not, oh, she's really pretty. I don't want you to consider that. I want you to consider these three things. Who do you really think, really, did the best when you talked to them, answered with the best according to these three things? So think about that. I'll give you a minute right now to just think in your head, and then afterwards, I'll call you each up, and you'll vote secretly. Nobody will ever know who you vote for. Nobody will ever know, so you don't have to worry about that. So you'll just come up here, and you'll vote. So think for a minute about these three things. Who do you want? Go ahead and think. G, just so you know, Rio, so you can vote. This is Rio, Rachel, Jeremy, Stan, Ukiah, Lynn, Tom, Bella, Julia, Fleur, Denny, Brian, and Paul. It's just for when you're voting, okay, so you know who's who. Does everybody have somebody in their mind that they think did the best job at this criteria? Does everybody have somebody in their mind? Yes?
Yeah.
Okay, then let's start. It looks like this, and you're just going to find the person you want and just touch it.
Yeah.
Okay. G, come on up.
Does anybody know?
Great question is crazy. Mm-hmm. Well, very impressive.
My vision is
very nice. All right, next, Rio.
I remember.
Did the best. Rachel!
Hand me the reason why you said about my heart.
Jeremy?
But if you have, please go and thank you. You describe about your heart.
Okay, so Jack, great. Stan! pretty girls.
Oh.
Yukaya.
Do you think?
Lynn? Tom? Vote well, guys, vote well. Bella?
No, I think they have an answer.
You don't have to share your answer. It's a secret. Come on up to
why is he
very good?
Do you mean? Tell me the reason why you have another perfect offer. If you have, tell me the very expensive of your girlfriend or
boyfriend. Danny boy!
I believe you are not your friend.
Brian? Jeremy, if this competition is the whitest shoes, you would win for sure. If our competition was whitest shoes, you would win. You'd be the winner. Very white. Just relax. Okay, I got it. So the answer. Oh, interesting. Three people.
Exciting.
You guys probably have an idea of who got it. The first person competing. These are not specifically in order. I'm just in the top three.
Yeah.
So maybe, you know, not in order. The first person competing for these three wonderful prizes is Denny Boy. And these prizes is
Lynn.
The third person competing for these amazing prizes is
Brian.
Great. So we have the three top. Now, what you're going to do is each of you are going to have 2 minutes to answer the question. Now, I'm going to be the final judge. Remember, there's no preparation. I know this isn't a presentation. It's just talking, you know, and trying to be concise, detailed, and clarity. Now, don't worry about it. Don't have any stress. Just, if you do good, fine. If you don't, fine. Don't worry about it.
Make sure.
Yeah.
What is the question?
I'm going to tell you now. Thanks, Rio. Question is...
I want to finish this.
Question is this. Most influential person you met. Now, I'm going to give you a minute and 30 to think about your answer. The rest of us are going to just sit back and watch them. Hope for the best. Stanley, who do you think will win? Sick guess. Who's going to win? I'm not in the competition, Stanley. Come on. Anyway, wow.
Lynn,
ooh, you know. Fan of Lynn. Brian, wow. It's going to be very interesting. So I'm hoping that you guys, Denny, Brian, Lynn, you're thinking about influential people.
Brian,
just relax. Brian, no stress, just relax. Doesn't matter. Now, finally, I'm going to be the final judge, and I'm going to decide who I think did the best of those three things. So, we got 30 seconds to think. And then afterwards, after the 30 seconds, these three people are going to do rock, scissors, paper to decide who goes first, second, and third.
Oh, yeah. Green.
Brian was break a leg.
Denny, if the helpless pants, you're going to win for sure.
Yeah.
Okay.
She is that human being.
All right. You three, rock, scissors, paper. Ready? Rock, scissors, paper. Okay, so you two, rock, scissors, paper. Okay, so you choose. Do you want to go first, second, or third? You want to go first.
Yeah.
Second or third?
Your third.
Oh, you need to shut up.
Lynn, are you ready? Come on up. Go ahead.
Oh,
Debbie, come on up.
Family or my best friend, but the most influential person to me is my father. Because, for example, when I was in high school, third grade, I can't concentrate on my study. I just read the philosophy, history books. I can't concentrate on my study, but I didn't tell him my problem, but he already knows. He already knew my problem, and he said he had a similar experiences when he was in high school. For example, also when I considering about the study subject in the university in the UK, he advised me to study business rather than politics with different reasons, and it's really a logic, and I can. I will change my subject because of my father's advice. So therefore, my father is the most influential person in my life. Thank you.
Fine. You ready? Remember, just answering it with normal speech. Good luck. Everybody quiet?
The most influential person in my life is my grandmother, because when I was young, before I entered my elementary school, I lived with my grandparents because my both parents had their job, so they lived separately with me in Nisa. So I spent most time, my time with my grandmother when I was in my childhood. And I remember she always said, before I go out, she told me, watch out the cars and watch out your people or person. So since childhood, I always remember her saying, watch out people. So whenever I meet person or other people, I really focused on my partner. So I think grandmother is the most important person in my life.
Okay. Alright, last one. Brian. Everyone, listen up. Go for it.
Yeah, when my high school was decided, I had no friends because my middle school was far from my high school, so I had no friends and I was really lonely. And I saw one person who had a lot of friends around him. His name was Gongja. He's one of my most influential person in my life. Originally, I had a bad temper, a little bit nasty. But when I was second grade in my high school, I had a chance to be a member of student council, and he was also the one, a student council. So we hang around, from that moment we hang around, and I was wondering
how can he how can he have a lot of friends around him? And I got to know that he always curious about the other was strange student, and he always to try to make a talk first and try to treat kindly. And I was really want to be that person. So because of him, I totally changed my life and the attitude.
Okay, wow. Yeah.
Well, let me tell you, Danny, Brian, Lynn, all of you did really good.
Very tough decision.
They're all did very good speaking. Very impressed.
In fact, everybody I was listening to earlier did really good. I think if I imagine when we first met, you know, at the first semester, your level is much, much higher than mine. I think you guys are speaking much better. So I'm happy about that. So I have a winner. And that winner is Rio. Drum roll.
Congratulations, speech.
Some of you have written it out and read it, which I don't like. But this is going to be the question, simple. And I want you, for your pronunciation homework, to speak for at least a minute and a half or more. Because I really want to have a sense of your pronunciation so I can give you feedback. Remember to concentrate on pronunciation, of course, grammar and everything else. I'm going to evaluate. Questions. So, all you do, same as before, audio record it, put it in the Dropbox, and that's it.
On this Thursday?
By Thursday, right. And by the way, I hope you guys organize your Dropbox. Some of you have and some of you haven't. Sometimes when I go through your Dropbox, it's like a messy bedroom. It's just like I can't find anything. So try to have a couple folders so I can easily find stuff. Mm-hmm. Don't have to search around. Okay?
Okay.
The idiom. Be under the weather.
Under the weather.
It's a, Rachel, are you under the weather? Rio, just take a guess. What does that mean? Just take a wild guess.
Change the, if weather is the sunny, then he or she mind is, his mind is very good, but if raining outside, then his mind is very gloomy.
Excellent guess. That's a really smart guess. It's not exactly right, but really good guess.
I know.
All right, then.
Bad feeling.
All right, bad feeling. Okay. What else? Any other guess? Bella, don't cheat. Kaka.
Do
homework.
Okay. What do you think it is, Bella? Do you think you can guess? Well, what do you think it is? This is a kind of a review. I think that we've talked about this, but some of you aren't remembering, so I'm just wondering. You can check your notes. We might have covered some. It's simple. It just means to be sick. Or, not feeling well.
it's not used for severe sickness. It's used for just light sickness. Like, you know, you got a headache, or maybe you have a stomach ache, something light, not that bad. Oh, I feel under the weather today. Understand?
Yeah.
Jeremy, just give me an example sentence using that, real quick. An example sentence, under the weather.
I was under the weather. Bingo.
Simple. Paul?
Not, I wasn't under the weather at Friday.
Oh, you weren't under the weather. Then why did you not come to class?
I wasn't.
Right, you weren't under the weather, so why didn't you?
I wasn't near the speaker.
Okay. All right, any questions about anything? Pronunciation, homework, speaking, life, anything?
Come on.
All right, y'all. See you tomorrow.